Hello everyone, welcome back to the discussion of the actions in QTP. So we have discussed about the basics of the actions, like how to create an action, how to delete it, how to rename it, and how to set the properties. In this video we are going to discuss about the live examples of the multiple actions, how to use the reusable actions, and so on. So before proceeding, let's have one question for you, and the question is an action that can be used in the same test script multiple times is non-reusable action or reusable action. Put your correct answer in the right box. Okay, you'll find the answer of this question in this video itself also. So just listen to the video very carefully. Okay, let's go to the QTP. I have the test created, and the test is searching a flight from our traveling site orbis.com. Okay, so what this test is doing, it is searching a flight, a one way option, and then search flights. Okay, so this test we have already created. Now, to create an example, our next test is what we want to do. We want to book a flight. So to book a flight, what is the steps here? We have to search flight first. Okay, then next is select the appropriate flight. Okay, and then do the booking related details. Okay, so in our case, we have a script for this already created. Now what we are going to do this, we are going to use this action and create these two steps in our new test. Okay. So to proceed ahead, let's make this action reusable first. Click on the option action from the action properties. Select the reusable action. It is already reusable. If it is not, you'll select this option and then press OK. Okay, now next is we'll create a new test. So open a test, and in this test, we'll record a step for booking. Okay, so let's do the recording. So we will record from this step. We have already searched the flight, and from here we'll select the first flight option and do the future booking. Okay, so let's do record option. Okay, select this first line, first flight. Okay, on this page we'll select the continue booking button here, continue booking, and again in the next page we'll select the continue booking button. We'll select this option, no, I'll travel without insurance. Okay, and we have to fill these details. Okay, so let's do the recording till here. Okay, let's just stop this. Okay, so now what we'll have this new test. What this test is doing, it is selecting the first flight and do the booking options. Okay, now we want to use the search flight code. We don't want to record again and again. Okay, so for using a reusable action, what we'll do, you can put the cursor over here, click the action option, and from here you will select the insert call to existing action. Select this option. Now here it will prompt you to select the action. Okay, we'll select that action. We have search flight. Okay, in that we have action 1, that is reusable. Okay, and the option is after the current step, then okay. Now see, here it will load that search flight action, and in the main action we have this statement, run action. What this will do, it will call the search flight action first, then it will perform the another operations. If you go to this action, see, you cannot edit this action. If you want to type anything, you cannot do. Why? Because it is an external action and you cannot edit the action. If you want to modify it, you need to go to the main test and then you have to modify it. Okay, so we have this new test. Okay, let's save it as a reusable action. Okay, Let's execute this code. Okay, now what this will do, see, it will first executing our reusable action, that is search flight. So it will search the flight first, executing the operations. Okay, see, now it come back to our main action. It is now looking for the select flight option. Okay, so it clicked the select option and then doing the booking operation. Continue booking button has been clicked. See, clicked. And now finally it select the option. Okay, so we have two actions executed over here. We'll see this from results also. If you go to the results, now see here, one is your search flight action, okay, and the another one is your actually action. So if you see all the performance that you have done into the search flight actions that are listed over here, and this is your action one summary. So in this way you can call the reusable action and use it within your test. If you go to the object repository, here two actions get listed. The one is your main action, the current test action, and the another one is your reusable action. If you select the reusable action, see, the options are disabled. Why? Because you cannot edit the objects of the external actions, whereas the local action you can update it as per your need accordingly. Okay, so this is how the actions works into the object repository. So there is a limitation of reusable action, is that you cannot edit it into the calling action. But if you want to use the same code, okay, and you want to update it, now there is another option for that. That is, just right click on the option action and select the option insert call to copy. It will create a copy of that action into your current test. Okay, so you have a separate copy of that action but with the same code, and this you can edit it. So select the option and you can select the test here. Let's select the search flight test itself. Okay, action, and here is the checkbox edit new action properties. It will allow you to edit the new action property. Select it and just press OK. Now see, it will prompt you for the name of the action. Let's create it as copied action. Do you want to make it reusable? Let's uncheck it. Okay. Now here see, you have one more action, that is a copied action. And see, it is not external action. This is the action of your test only. And in the object repository, you will see all the objects from the external file also gets copied to your this action. Okay, so you can create a copy of the action also. Now you can do the editing here. Okay, because this is your action now. The only difference is you create a copy of the action. You have copied all the text from that action. Okay, so you have three options. Either you can call a new action, you can call an existing action, or you can call a copy of action. Okay, now if you have a code of so many number of lines, okay, and you want to make it a modular and you want to break it, you can do it as well. You can split an action as well. So to split an action, put the cursor on that step from where you want to split the action. Okay, let's say we want to split the action from this step. Okay, so let's say put the cursor over here. Okay, here, and now select the option from here, split action. Now here the options are like independent of each other. It means, do you want two separate action like this, action one, action two, or you want a nested action? Nested means within another, like in this action you will have one more action. Okay, let's create one independent of each other. So we have copied action 1 and then copied action 2. then press OK. Now if you see in the action, see, now you have two action. The one is copied action 1, where you have three steps, and the next is copied action 2, where you have another three steps. Okay, so in this way you can create two nested actions. Now next option is go to the split action again. It is prompting for the save changes. Okay, now select the nested option. Okay, and I have created, let's say, A1, and within this A2. Okay, then press OK. Now if you see here, A1 is here and now A2 is here. Within action A1, you have a call to run action A2. Okay, so this way you can split your actions as per your need. If you have different modules in the same script, you can split your actions, and you can use the reusable action like this. You can use the reusable actions n number of times in the same script. Like this, you can call the existing action. Okay, then select the search flight. Okay, now see, you have a search flight call in A1 as well, like here, and in your action 1 as well, here. So you can call the reusable action n number of times in the test. Okay, so you can use this feature, like use the reusable actions, split the actions in n number of times. That's all about the actions with the multiple options. Thank you.